Good evening friends. Today we will discuss about one more name reaction in our organic chemistry called Novenegal condensation reaction. Okay, what is that? Novenegal condensation reaction. Let us see. Before going to start about this Novenegal condensation reaction, you should have to know about some dicarboxylic acid containing compounds. Basically, you know very well about this functional group. What is this functional group called? Carboxylic acid. This is another carboxylic acid moiety. If both the carboxylic acids are separated by one particular carbon atom, that means like this, it is called malonic acid. Okay, what is this dicarboxylic acid name? Malonic acid. The purpose of discussing about this particular dicarboxylic acid is just to write the full form of the dicarboxylic acid structure. This is the dicarboxylic acid structure. Both the carboxylic acid moieties are separated by a single carbon atom. Okay, so this particular moiety is called methylene group. What is this called? Methylene group. Methylene moiety. In the same manner, we can also write its ester form. This is diethyl ester of diethyl ester of malonic acid. This is malonic acid. This is diethyl ester of, it is a diethyl ester of malonic acid. It is a diethyl ester of malonic acid. So what is the difference between these two? In this particular case, this is a simple carboxylic acid moiety. This is substituted with one alkyl moiety. The acidic hydrogen is replaced with ethyl moiety. Okay, purpose of replacing this one is it is a electron withdrawing group. It makes the group which is more withdrawing in nature. Okay, so this methylene moiety is substituted with two electron withdrawing groups. What is the purpose of these two electron withdrawing groups? Whenever these two carbons are going to withdraw electrons, then this particular carbon, alpha carbon, has a tendency to donate H plus ions very freely. So, hence this methylene moiety is called active methylene moiety. What is this called? Active methylene moiety. It is a simple methylene moiety. When compared this carboxylic acid moiety, this alkyl ester moiety is strong electron withdrawing group when compared with carboxylic acid. The purpose of taking this particular molecule is due to presence of electron withdrawing group, this methylene moiety has a tendency to release H plus ions very freely. Hence it is called active methylene moiety containing esters. Active methylene moiety containing carboxylic acids or esters. Among these two, which one is more active methylene moiety containing molecule? Diethyl ester of malonic acid. Okay? Right. Next one. Let us come to organic bases. Basically, in our organic chemistry, amines are also called bases. Okay? Amines are also called bases. For example, tell me some bases. Alkyl amines or aryl amines or heterocyclic amines. it is a pyridine. It is a pyridine, or you can also write the structure of pyridine like this. Okay, or piperidine. These are all organic bases. Okay, remember these two types of molecules. In the first case, what is the molecule? Active methylene group containing compounds. What is this? Organic base. Now let us see the Novenegal condensation reaction. Okay, so what is this Novenegal condensation reaction? Actually, it is one type of condensation reaction. What is that? It is one type of condensation reaction. In this particular case, see, it is one type of condensation reaction or coupling reaction. Condensation or coupling reaction, in which aromatic carbonyl compounds react with active methylene group containing compounds. Active methylene group containing compounds to produce alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds, especially alpha beta unsaturated carboxylic acids are also formed in presence of organic bases like pyridine or piperidine. What is this Novenegal condensation reaction? It is a coupling reaction or condensation reaction in which active methylene group containing carbonyl compounds react with aromatic aldehydes or ketones, aromatic carbonyl compounds, to yield alpha beta unsaturated carboxylic acids or carbonyl compounds. Okay, this reaction only catalyzed in presence of organic bases like pyridine or piperidine. Now you may get one doubt. So why don't we use sodium ethoxide or potassium ethoxide? Okay, so this reaction doesn't need the help of strong bases because it's a active methylene group. Easily it can donate H plus ions. No need to use the strong base. Okay, so that's the reason we can use a simple organic basis. Let us see the overall reaction. Okay, see. For example, what is this? Benzaldehyde. When react with active methylene group containing carboxylic acids or carbonyl compounds or their derivatives, what is this? Diethyl ester of malonic acid to yield alpha beta unsaturated compounds in presence of what is that? Base, that is pyridine, to yield alpha beta unsaturated alpha beta unsaturated carboxylic acid. This is also called cinnamic acid. Okay, under which category it comes? Alpha beta unsaturated alpha beta unsaturated carboxylic acid. Okay, so this is the overall Nobenegal reaction, the Nobenegal condensation reaction. Okay, what is a Nobenegal condensation reaction? Aromatic aldehydes are ketones in presence of active methylene group containing carboxylic acids or esters to yield alpha beta unsaturated carboxylic acids. These are also called cinnamic acid or their derivatives also. Okay, let us see the mechanism one by one. Okay, what is step one? What is this called? Active methylene group containing ester in presence of a pyridine base, it yields one of the H plus will get taken by the lone pair of electrons of nitrogen. So thereby it yields carbanion is formed plus protonated pyridine positive charge because of the hydrogen. Okay, or simply you can write pyridine plus the abstracted proton. Okay, what is the step one? Formation of carbanion. So under that step one, when active methylene group containing esters in presence of base undergo deprotonation to yield carbanion, which acts as a nucleophile. Now that nucleophile attacks onto our carbonyl compound, aromatic carbonyl compound. So attack of carbanion onto the electrophilic carbon of benzaldehyde, partial negative charge, partial positive charge. Now it attacks onto the electrophilic carbon of benzaldehyde to yield, what is that? Alkoxide. What is that? Alkoxide. Now you can see that alkoxide product. O minus. Now, the attacked nucleophilic part it is. right? Now, this alkoxide undergo protonation. Alkoxide form of intermediate undergo protonation to yield alcohol. CHO in presence of acid. This acid from already abstracted proton. OC2H5. Okay, right. So, this is, what is the name of this product? Simply you can say that alpha 1 hydroxy benzyl malonic ester. This is a malonic ester. Alpha carbon is substituted with benzyl moiety. In that benzyl moiety at first position hydroxy moiety. So hence alpha 1 hydroxy benzyl diethyl ester of malonic acid. Okay, so this is step 3. Step 1, formation of carbanion. Step 2, attack of carbanion onto the electrophilic carbon of benzaldehyde to yield alkoxide ion. Third step, protonation of alkoxide to form beta hydroxy product, alpha carbonyl compound, alpha beta hydroxy product. Or if you take this one as a parent, this is alpha carbon atom, this is beta carbon atom. Okay, so at alpha position there is a one substituted benzyl moiety, hence alpha, start the bracket, 1 hydroxy benzyl diethyl ester of malonic acid. Okay, let us see what will happen next. In the fourth step, what type of functional groups these are? Ester groups. Those particular esters undergo hydrolysis. Just I want to add, not hydrolysis, dehydration. Beta hydroxy product generally undergo dehydration to yield alpha beta unsaturated diester. Alpha beta unsaturated diester. Okay, this is a beta hydroxy diester. This is alpha beta. Sorry, here there is no hydrogen because it was already removed in the form of water molecule. H plus. OH minus. Okay, so in the fourth step, alpha beta hydroxy benzyl diethyl ester of malonic acid undergo dehydration to yield alpha beta unsaturated diester. Okay, so you know very well about the stability of esters. generally esters are very weak functional groups. They readily undergo hydrolysis to yield carboxylic acids and alcohols. Now our product, what is that? Ester. The ester undergo hydrolysis. How many ester molecules are there? 2 ester molecules. So that's why 2 water molecules are required. So 1 water molecule was already formed in the reaction. Yes or no? So you have to take another water molecule from outside. Just I want to take another water molecule. Esters undergo hydrolysis to yield carboxylic acids and alcohols. So in this particular case, whatever the ester bond is there, these bonded electrons are more dense towards to oxygen, because oxygen is more electronegative. So thereby carbon attains positive charge. Onto this positive charge, nucleophile attacks. Onto this positive charge, nucleophile attacks. Now our product is double bond C, C double bond O. OH. Another one is C double bond O, OH. Now alpha beta unsaturated dicarboxylic acid is formed. Alpha beta unsaturated dicarboxylic acid is formed. So if you apply little amount of heat or at low temperature only, this molecule undergo one particular chemical reaction. Now I will show you what is that chemical reaction, because dicarboxylic acids are highly unstable also. C double bond O. OH, another one also carboxylic acid moiety, double bond O. OH, in presence of heat, in presence of heat, generally the bond between oxygen and hydrogen will get broken down. So in that particular case, it will see, generally in presence of heat, in presence of low temperature, this is ionic bond or covalent bond? Ionic bond. So at normal temperature, this ionic bond undergo heterolytic cleavage, because it's very weak bond. If you apply high amount of heat, it undergo homolytic cleavage to yield free radical. Now what may be happen? Oxygen free radical and hydrogen free radical. To compensate that oxygen free radical, the bond between carbon and carbon also undergo homolytic cleavage. Thereby, what will be the product? C double bond O, one free radical here. At the same time, oxygen free radical, hydrogen free radical. Already here one more free radical is going to be formed. Now free radical formation of bond. So what is going to be eliminated? CO2. Now there is a removal of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide. There is a removal of carbon dioxide to yield C. This hydrogen free radical attacks onto this one. usually this carboxylic acid is there. There is a formation of carboxylic acid. What type of carboxylic acid it is? Alpha, beta, unsaturated carboxylic acid. Unsaturated carboxylic acid is also called cinnamic acid. Okay, so it has how many step reaction? 6-step reaction. In the first step, active methylene group containing ester in presence of base to yield carbanion. In the next step, formation of alkoxide. In the next step, beta hydroxy form is formed. In the next step, dehydration of beta hydroxy product to yield alpha beta unsaturated. The next one, undergo hydrolysis to yield dicarboxylic acids. In the last step, decarboxylation of dicarboxylic acid to yield monocarboxylic acid, that is called alpha beta unsaturated carboxylic acid. Okay, these are the various steps involved in the formation of alpha beta unsaturated carboxylic acid. As like Perkin condensation, this is also one of the simplest method than Perkin condensation. Though it contains 6-step reaction, it is very simple reaction to process out carry out in our organic chemistry laboratory, because in the Perkin condensation we are using acetic anhydride. So in our India, acetic anhydride is banned. So that's why this is the simplest method to synthesize alpha beta unsaturated carboxylic acid. The main reason for banning acetic anhydride in our India is, you know very well about the narcotic drug molecule that is called morphine. If that morphine undergo acetylation, heroin is going to be produced. That is the simple method nowadays our Indians are going to synthesize heroin from morphine. Okay, if morphine undergo acetylation by 2 times, that is going to produce heroin. That's the reason acetic anhydride is banned in our India. Okay, so this is the simplest method to synthesize alpha beta unsaturated carboxylic acids. Okay, so with this, Novenigel condensation reaction is finished. Thank you.